when the sun is up. I've got something I can laugh about. I feel good, and in a special way. I know that it's a sunny day. Good day, sunshine. Shining down, it burns my feet as they touch the ground. Shady tree. I love her when she's loving me. She feels good and she knows she's looking fine. I'm so proud and I know she's mine. Good day, sunshine. Good day, sunshine.
is different. Good morning, everybody. Nice to see you. And here's Reverend Sandy.
Oh, just breathing in and experiencing all of you who are here. Good morning and welcome to Unity of Michiana Spiritual Center. And good morning to all of you who are joining us via our live stream service. We know that in the ethers of all creation and all that is, we are connected heart to heart, spirit to spirit. So we are gathered here together today in our hearts, in our very being. At Unity of Michiana, we're a heart-centered, a multi-generational, and a diverse spiritual community dedicated to teaching and practicing a positive life approach in our spiritual journey. And our vision is a world united in loving acceptance, celebrating inclusivity, harmony, prosperity, and awakened consciousness. And so we're glad that you're here with us today. It's the first Sunday in February, not quite sure. I'm still thinking it's before Christmas, but maybe not, yes. So, but it is the first Sunday of February, and so we will be celebrating February birthdays in just a little bit. So for those of you who are at home on our live stream, Vicki, that includes you. My sister has birthday in February, so please post your names so that we can include you when we sing happy birthday in just a little while. So Catherine's already ready. Thank you so much for lighting our Christ candle. So join with me in spirit in this moment, in awareness of the flow of all that is, of the oneness that is creation, of which we are a part, of which we contribute to. And in this moment, as we open our hearts, our very being, we can feel that energy, that flow, healing us, blessing us, lifting us up, joining us together. And so we give thanks as we gather in this oneness, as we celebrate our own awareness that contributes to the greater whole of our world. We say thank you, God. Amen. And now have our youth come forward.
I ask that you rub your hands together. We see you surrounded in the light of God.
We see you surrounded in the light of God.
And we hold you close in our hearts.
And we hold you close in our hearts. So those of you who have birthdays in February, we'll ask you to come forward, and Susan, you can let me know those names that show up on there. And so we're going to have Sue Ann, Martha, Sue Ellen, and Sue Ann. Oh, man. Come on up, so everybody can see you guys. Come on in. Everybody wants to see. There we go. And Susan, I know my sister Vicki has a February birthday. And who else?
Nobody else has said anything on the live stream, but I want to mention that Emil Toth and Richard Krauss also have.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Yes, indeed. Let's celebrate Emil and Richard as well. So take it away, Maestro.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Blessing you, are wonderful. God is blessing you now.
And so let's rub our hands together and we just beam forth this wonderful energy that celebrates their life and this day and this wonderful expression of being out into the world. And we say, we see you filled with the light of God.
We see you filled with the light of God.
And we see blessings overflowing, abounding in your life.
And we see
blessings overflowing, abounding in your lives. Yes. Thanks and blessings. Happy birthday all. And John, I'll turn it over to you for our music.
Yeah, I think we used to do this one a lot. That's Sam. So I believe you guys will know it. Sing loud. I'm not the strongest at playing hymns, so cover me up. Open my eyes that I might hear. Beautiful. It is of truth it says for me. Place in my hands the wonderful key that I'll unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, I will to see. Open my eyes, illumine. Hear it divine. Open my ears that I may hear. Glimpses of truth I hand it clear. And while my wave knows in my ear, everything false will disappear. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my ears and illumine. Spirit divine. Open my mouth and let me bear. Hand thee the warm truth everywhere. Open my ears and let me prepare. Love with my children thus to share. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart and do this. I just imagine it, just imagine it, just imagine how it could be. I can see myself as I want to be and be the way I want to be. Just imagine it. Just imagine it, just imagine how it could be. I can see myself as I want to be and be the way I want to be. Imagine it, just imagine it, just imagine how it could be. I can see myself as I want to be and be the way I want to be and be the way I want to be.
That brings back some wonderful memories for me. Of course, you all know I grew up in Southern California, and my sister and I went to the Pomona Unity Church there. And on Wednesday evenings, Carmen Mosier had all of a sudden begun writing all these wonderful, uplifting songs. This song we just sang was Carmen Mosier's. And oh, man, so I was, I don't know, in high school or little younger than that maybe, and we'd come on Wednesdays and we'd sing, and I'd go through the whole week, and all those songs would just reverberate through me and carrying that positive energy. So it was wonderful that you ended up picking that one, John, and I'm sure my sister enjoyed it as well. So thank you so much. In Unity, we have our wonderful Daily Word publication with an inspirational message for each day of the week, and I'll ask Martha to come forward and read our Daily Word for today, and we'll follow that with a time of meditation and prayer.
Our Daily Word for today, Sunday, February 4th, is joy. Joy is mine through all the seasons of life. Throughout my life, joy is always a part of me, like the sun that is always shining, even when obscured by the clouds. Joy is there in my happiest moments and also during my darker times. It keeps me present to life as it unfolds, responsive and adaptive, accepting what I cannot change and having the courage to change what I can. Much more than a feeling, joy is part of me, a way to feel the presence of God and live from my spirituality. Joy is the anchor that keeps me rooted in peace and wholeness, and the wings that help me soar through the open skies of imagination and choice. My spiritual identity has its foundations in the divine idea of joy, and I carry it with me wherever I go and in everything I do. You show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy. Psalms 16:11. Our daily word for today is joy.
Martha, thank you so much. Oh, this is one of my favorite times. I just invite you to join with me. This is your own time, our own time, to move into and reconnect to the very heart of our being, the very source of all that is, the oneness of God. So I invite you just to kind of relax wherever you are, at home or here in the room, to breathe, to choicefully shift that focus of attention from the busyness of the thoughts down into the solar plexus, the seat of our soul, our very beingness. And as I tone our singing bowl, feel the resonance of that toning, that musical, energetic vibration. Connect with and to and move through all of who you are. And we breathe and we forget in just that simple act of being, the in-breath and the out-breath, that we are literally in an active prayer of receptivity and of release, which is the yin and the yang of all that is creation, inflow and the outflow. The sunrise, the sunset. It is the dance of all moving synchronistically. And with each breath that we take, it is our own body's prayer. Infilling, receptive, open, abundantly blessed. And the out breath, that releases tension, negativity, things that are no longer useful, in order to make room for the inflow of that which is of the greatest good for us. And so as we just begin to relax into this cadence of breathing, recognizing it is the natural design of our body, it is the natural design of our universe, it is present in and through all things and all creation. The inflow and the outflow. And so we feel ourselves in that pattern of synchronicity, in the breath of awareness that we are all one. We are all connected. Does not mean that we are the same. It simply means that we are all a part of that which is creation, creator, becoming. We are all creative. We all have a wisdom and a light and a beauty to share. We all have laughter. We all have those things that we grieve. We all have the challenges of life. And yet we recognize that we are a part of the constancy, the assuredness of the inflow and the outflow. Ever abundance. Creation from limitless substance and all that is ever becoming. So we just gently immerse ourselves in the light and the oneness and the love of that flow. As we take a moment in silence to receive the gifts of that awareness, of that connection. And we relax into and in that place of receptivity, we naturally just simply rest in gratitude in the silence. And in this place of universal oneness, the sense of peace that fills our soul, our very being, the light that illuminates away the darkness, the love that heals and blesses, that forgives and uplifts and embraces. With open and grateful hearts, we say thank you, infinite spirit of beingness. And so we take a moment to surround our prayer box in light, to speak aloud the names of those friends, people we would bless, colleagues, world situations. Let us, through the power of the spoken word, set that prayerful intention forth. Donlin, Noah, Kelsey, Jocelyn, Karen, Bob, Teresa, Terry, Wanda, Mary, Unity of Michiana, Unity Worldwide Ministries World Headquarters, Jolene, Richard, and so we send forth our prayers, our intentions, knowing they are embraced in the flow of universal energy for greater good. We release them unto that higher presence. With gratitude, we say thank you, and so it is.
I love this song since I was a little kid. I think I was attracted to just the bright spirit of it. But had no idea at the time. Back then, I just knew I liked it. So anyway, I hope you enjoy it. See clearly now the rain is gone. I can see all obstacles in my way. Down on the dark clouds that had me blind, it's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Go ahead and do the answers if you want. Gonna be a bright sunshiny day. I think I can make it now, the rain is gone, all of the bad feelings have disappeared. Here is that rainbow I've been praying for. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. And all around is nothing but blue sky. Look straight ahead, it's nothing but blue sky. See all obstacles in my way. Gone are the dark clouds that had me blind. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. It's gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Oh, what a bright sunshiny day. It's a bright sunshiny day. Gone all the rainbow I've been bright sunshiny day. All the troubles are fleeting now. Bright sunshiny day. Gone all the dark clouds that had me to bright sunshiny day. It's a bright sunshiny day. Gonna be a bright sunshiny day. Wish I could have got you guys to sing along a little more. I was supposed to say something in the beginning, but you know. It's confusing up here sometimes. Here's Reverend Sandy.
Was there something you wanted to say?
Oh, I wanted more like more bright and more like singing along. But
oh, the direction song? for the congregational choir here, right? Yeah. Oh.
With me.
Well, you know, Chrissy just, she knows, she just gets right in there. So she was a big help. Yeah. Oh, gosh, friends, I'm so excited about the talk for today. My title is The Power of Creative Visioning. And I will apologize just in advance. I have some sort of a sinus thing going on. And so I think I caught something from my cats because I keep coughing up hairballs. But it gets a little bad at times. But I really am fine. And I don't have any COVID or anything like that. It's just a little bit of sinus. So I apologize if that interrupts. So I won't have to say anything later on. So. But friends, oh my gosh, we are moving into a new year. And so we went through a wonderful process. We did the burning bowl. We let go of the stuff that we carried and ready to, okay, move on. So we did the burning bowl. Then we did the white stone, which is that place where we tune into our own creative, intuitive soul, self, and knowing to find that one word or one or two words that helps us in how we will move forward into this brand new year. And last year, we did our letter to God, to our God self, our soul self, where we began to set forth the dreams and the visions and what our heart, our soul, our very being calls us in to be living forward in our lives. And yet, like with New Year's Eve resolutions and different things when we start the year and I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do that, and I'm going to do that. And then the humanness of us kind of comes in, does it not? And it's like, well, do I really want to do that? Or is that really true? Or how can I change that much? Because from our human, egoic, personal mind, we see our world through the limited viewpoint of these eyes. And so I want to talk to us today about the dynamic power that lies in creative visioning, that takes us out of our human experiences out here into the realm of infinite possibility, the truth of all being. And so, friends, truly, what stands behind creative visioning are ancient universal laws, spiritual laws, that have existed throughout time, ancient Egyptians, Romans, Jesus studied, Fillmore's studied. So many, all the religions of the world are founded, friends, in universal principles. In unity, sometimes we call them unity principles, and they're sort of condensed down to five basic types of things. They are universal truths. Unity and the Fillmores in their studies had an awareness and so kind of culled it down to help us understand that. And yet we lose sight so often of those very simple and basic faculties of being that allow us to creatively manifest. The very first and most important ancient spiritual principle is the same as unity's first principle. And it says, there is only one presence. It doesn't say there's only one, or there's us and another extra deity outside of me. It says, there is only one presence and one power, active as the universe. A presence and a power active as the universe and in my life, in all of our lives. Now we put the word God. In ancient Hebrew, it was Yahweh, or simply the letters, because the sacredness of the energetic vibration of that name was so powerful that people did not speak the name aloud. Of course, we know God, G-O-D, is Germanic, is anglicized, means good. But there's only one presence and one power active as the universe and in our lives, and it's omnipotence. It's goodness. And so when we start to recognize this very great one presence and one power is active everywhere and in all things and as us, and we have that capacity as we begin to remember and to recognize our oneness with infinite spirit, that we forget all the time. Because oftentimes we misunderstand a lot of the stories in the Bible. They're metaphysical, they're allegorical. They're not meant to be, so some of them are very historical. And yet a lot of the stories are meant to teach a spiritual lesson, to speak of the evolution of spiritual humanity. So we all know about Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, right? Okay, well, what in the heck does that mean, really? Were there two beings and they got kicked out because somebody ate an apple and blah, blah, blah? No. Metaphysically and spiritually, what that story represents about humanity is that place within us which we choicefully, so we stepped out of the quote-unquote Garden of Eden, which is the awareness of wholeness and oneness. We stepped apart and separate from into the egoic self. Now, is this a bad thing? No, it's not something to be slapped for and everybody says, oh, original sin. No, it's a part of the building of the creation of humanity in its own understanding of itself. And it took that separation in our own thinking, which we end up seeing our world out here through limited eyes rather than through the eyes of the wholeness and the allness. It has taken that separation and then time for us as humanity to evolve back into the oneness. But those ancient principles of truth, which is we are in and of the design of the allness, call us into the power to create, to manifest forth, true to our own original design. Way back in the time of 161 AD, Marcus Aurelius. He was the Roman emperor, a Stoic philosopher, and he says, all things are linked with one another, and this oneness is sacred. There is nothing that is not interconnected with everything else, for things are interdependent, and they combine to form this universal order. There is only one universe made up of all things, and one creator who pervades them. There is one substance and one law. Substance, we use that a lot in unity, and I can remember growing up with a word, and I'm like, well, what in the heck does that mean? Well, it's kind of our, you know, and then science has put names on the ethers that Charles Fillmore also said. It's the atoms and the quarks and the, you know, all the stuff out there. So I'm not scientific, but it's a recognition of the stuff of which our universe is made. And it's the energy of the one presence and the one power. It's the beingness, friends. And the Fillmores and other people in New Thought who have, like, Abraham Hicks, Chandler, people, I'm just trying to think off the top of my head again. So many people have an awareness, Deepak Chopra, and of the power that we forget we have. Because as we separated, as we stepped out of the knowingness that we are all one, as we stepped into our own identity and separated out into this vision out here rather than the wholeness, then we forgot. We forgot the power of creation, the power of creator within us and as us. And so as we step back into recognizing the power of creative visioning, which is actually prayer, it's actually how we connect into that potentiality of infinite substance and source. It's about our remembering our oneness. And in scripture, and Jesus said this from John 10:30, he said, the Father and I are one. Now, you know, what happens because we've got anglicized wording in the Bible, Father, we go to this, you know, super being outside of us. He's referring to the energetic presence of all that is, that we are all one. And in Ephesians 4:4-6, it says, there is one body and one spirit, one Lord, one faith, one God of all, who is over all and through all and in all. And in Acts 17:28, for in him, in the allness, in the presence, in the flow and the energy of spirit, we live and move and have our being, friends. And so as you begin writing your letters last week, and as you continue to formulate them forward in your creative visioning into this year for yourself, it's about moving into an awareness of these ancient spiritual principles that God is our source. That God, not a God person, but God, the energy, the Yahweh, the flow of life, is limitless. And a source that we can call upon when we recognize our oneness. And we do that through prayer. Breathing is prayer. Intention is prayer. Thoughts are prayer. And we begin utilizing that to connect and to then lay hold of that which we do not see with our human eyes, but which we create with the mind of infinite allness, with the spirit and the soul of our being. So we go to the second unity truth principle through prayer and, well, it's not the second one, but it's one of the five. And it's through prayer and meditation, we align our heart mind with God. So, friends, if we're to be about the power and invoking that power of creative visioning, ancient spiritual laws, it is about taking time apart. Now, taking time apart doesn't mean not being out in the world. It doesn't mean you have to go down on your knees. It doesn't mean going up to the hilltop necessarily. It just means a willingness to step into your own truthful soul being, to focus, to see differently than the eyes that see out here and believe this is our outer, our reality, and to try and manifest and go, okay, car up here in the parking lot right now. You know, we do that, and our minds go, well, no, of course not. Part of us kind of does, though, doesn't it? And we're so used to the ones being in charge, right? So we think when we start putting forth intention and creative belief and dreams that we then have to make it happen. And all that's up to us to do is to remember the oneness and connect into that and know we are a part of it and that we have the capacity to lay hold of that substance, that energy of all that is our universe. It's limitless, friends. And oh man, our human mind just like goes, wait a minute. No, there's limitations and there's this and there's that and I can't dream big dreams and how can I possibly do that? And friends, it is truly about, in prayer, simply aligning ourselves in the remembrance of the true design in which we are created, in the image and likeness of God, in the image and likeness of universal presence or force or beingness. Many of you are familiar with Linda Martella Witsit. Excuse me, just a minute. She's a longtime Unity minister. She has been a part of Silent Unity. She's been a part of Daily Word. She's written many books. We've done book studies in the past. She just recently wrote a new book. I know, Sue Ellen, you discovered that probably on the Unity site, and I ordered it back when Great Lakes Region had her as their guest speaker in the fall, and she was a presenter, and she addresses the principles of Unity that sometimes we have stepped away from, and she invites us back into affirmative prayer in a way that we have forgotten. But she pulls in the teachings and the ideas, the original teachings and ideas of both Myrtle and of Charles. And so it's so inspiring what she says about prayer. She says, affirmative prayer is a completely different form of prayer. It's the teaching of oneness, meaning there is only one divine power, and therefore God and humanity are one in absolute truth. The teaching of oneness, meaning there is only one divine power and therefore God and humanity are one in absolute truth, changes prayer. It changes envisioning. It changes our intentions. It changes everything. Rather than presuming the power we seek is outside and separate from us, affirmative prayer empowers us to respond to life circumstances by drawing upon the truth of oneness, friends. Of knowing that we are so much more than just our outer physical selves. And her book is magnificent, Discover Your Divinity, I think as is the title. The Wednesday group is going to be starting a little bit of a discussion and a reading of that book in a few weeks. So you'll listen for some announcements. You can join in the Zoom group. It's powerful, powerful realigning and remembering of the truth of who we are, the power we have to create, the design, the opportunity. And it is through prayer, and we have an idea in our mind of what prayer is, and it's shifting that. It's not asking for something outside of ourselves. It's standing in that intention and that awareness within us and knowing that that connects us into the flow. It's like, you know, sticking, you know, the plug into the electrical outlet. It's like, pew. And it all begins to move because we have choicefully recognized and opened the portal to allow that through our intention and through our focus. So from our founder, Charles Fillmore, one reading from 12 Powers of Man says, we find there is in man a knowing capacity transcending intellectual knowledge. When we discover in ourselves a flow of thought that seems to have been evolved independently of our reasoning process, our intellectual brain, we are often puzzled about its origin. In its beginnings, this seemingly strange source of knowledge is often turned aside as a daydream. How many of us said, oh, well, that's silly. Oh, you know, no, I should focus on this, or this is what's real, and don't, you know, don't be off in flights of fancy. He goes on to say, one should give attention to this usually faint whispering of spirit in man, in humanity. It is not of the intellect and does not originate in the skull. This is verbiage from 150 years ago. The brain, it is the development in man of a greater capacity to know himself and understand creation, friends. Understand our power to create out of that which we cannot see, out of that which we haven't even known before. And he goes on to say in Jesus Christ Heals, prayer is dynamic and accentuates the spiritual ethers that interpenetrate all substance. Prayer is related directly to the creative laws of God, and when man adjusts his mind and body in harmony with these laws, with oneness, with our capacity to co-create, his prayers will always be effective and far-reaching. So Scripture teaches us in Matthew 6:33, but seek first the kingdom of God, and all these things will be added to you. Seek first the kingdom of God, meaning seek first the core of your soul being. Seek first the flow of universal presence, and all these things will be added unto you. And from Matthew 7:7-8, Charles, in one of his books, did a little bit of an intro to that. He said, the highest exercise of the mind is prayer, and prayer is accumulative, or like a continued focus or a continual affirmation. This is a teaching of Jesus, and we find that it is good metaphysical law to ask, and it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks, it will be opened, friends. So when we set our intentions, when we go forward, we are calling upon our imagination, the joy and the delight of beginning to move into that which we haven't even known before, we haven't seen before. And there are no limitations to infinite spirit. So friends, aligned in oneness with all creative being, we manifest our vision. When we align ourselves prayerfully, focused fully, intentionally, we access that positive expression of creativity and of being that we were designed in order to manifest forth and participate in. And all of you know in Scripture from Hebrews 11:1, now faith is the assurance of things expected, the evidence of things not yet seen. How many times have we heard that? And yet from the human physical plane, we want to, you know, we say seeing is believing, right? And in metaphysics, we say believing is seeing. It's that time to shift into the willingness to dream big dreams, to let your imagination fly. To recognize that it is not up to us to know how, but to simply believe in the creative possibility that we are engaging in. And when we do that, in Deuteronomy 28 Scripture, it says, verse 12, it says, the Lord will open the heavens, the storehouse of his bounty, to send rain on your land in season and to bless all the work of your hands, friends. When we choose to implement one of the third principles that Unity talks about, a third, we're beeping. Are we okay, Kevin? Okay, good. That was so we would pay attention because this is real important, okay? That was like, beep, beep, beep. Okay, everybody, focus. Okay, wake up. Okay. But it's one of the most important ancient spiritual laws, and it's incorporated into unity as truth principles. We are co-creators with God, creating and manifesting through thoughts held in mind. How often have we heard, thoughts held in mind create after their kind? We've been, the law of attraction through has been out there through, so many people have focused on that. Charles and Myrtle Fillmore were some of the first that really brought that forth. But it's truth, friends. And our minds are going to want to stick it off to the side and say, no, you know, it's not possible. It can't be. And I'm trying to remember who said, Jean-Luc Picard said, I don't have one of the slides for that, but Jean-Luc Picard said, it's only impossible until it isn't, friends. And it's up to us to begin to step away from all the rules and the regulations and the places that we box ourselves in, because that faith in what we can't see, it's hard to lay hold of, isn't it? It's hard to trust in that universal substance providing, because we oftentimes see so much that seems very real, that is of lack and is not an abundance in our life. And yet as we choicefully take hold of an awareness of our oneness with the force of all creation of the universe, and as we begin to just put forward in all of our affairs the recognition that there are no limitations of that positive manifestation we can bring forth, then we indeed change our world. E.W. Kenyon, who was a pastor, and he says, faith talks in the language of God, but doubt talks in the language of man. Isn't that true? It does. And so it's recognizing when the doubts come up to know that that's not the true voice of our soul self. Carl Sandburg, Pulitzer Prize poet and a journalist, he says, nothing happens unless first we dream. How many of you as kids were said, don't daydream, don't look out the window, do something productive? Those are old, not everybody got those, but those are old visions and teachings that are really important from the human level for us to dismantle, to release and to let go. Excuse me. And from Abraham, from Esther Hicks, she and her husband were inspirational speakers. She was a channeler. They were authors. She said, it's not your work to make anything happen. I go, well, then nothing's going to go on, right? Because we're programmed. Get out there and do. Just do it, right? Goes on to say, it's your work to dream it. It's your work to visualize it, to use that power of creative visioning. That's your work. To be willing to let your imagination fly free and just dwell in that realm of focusing on it, praying about it, being a part of it, and making it, feeling it within your body. It's your work to dream it and let it happen. Within the seed of your desire is everything necessary for it to blossom to fulfillment. And we've been so taught to do the doing rather than to be the being. So friends, as we live into the power of creative visioning, and as you've written your letters, and maybe you'll continue to write your own letters or add some things or put up some post-it notes, just listen to the heart and the soul of your being. Listen to that voice that is the all-pervasive presence of infinite oneness, possibility, as it draws you to new ideas, to new things, to new ways of being, and recognize how in our world the limitations show up and how we tend to just run with that. How about how we view our political scene? Do we oftentimes feel there's nothing we can do about it? And then we're focused on that spiral. Creative visioning is about focusing on the truth of our heart and our being and what we see as a world that's free, a world that is equal, a world that harmonizes and embraces all. So when you start running down, you know, the political rabbit hole, come back. Creative power of visioning. What about in your lives, with your job, with your finances? You start to go down, you know, that rabbit hole of old beliefs, of old fears, of old doubts. Just take a moment to play in the field of the imagination, to play in the field of oneness, in the field of all potentiality. That is our inherent birthright. That is who we are. And so I will close with a quote from Oprah Winfrey. Create the highest, grandest vision possible for your life, because you become what you believe. So friends, as we go forward into this new year, let's enjoy and celebrate and create and empower ourselves by choicefully shifting into the truth of our oneness, our wholeness, our creative imagination, and becoming all that we can be. So I'm going to shift now and share a few of our happenings and events. So our annual membership meeting is coming up on February 25th. We want to invite all of you to join in that meeting. There are a few votes that will be taken, and the votes are taken by those who are actually recommitted members at the end of 2023. And if you recommitted your membership, then you are part of the voting membership. But this spiritual community is made up of everyone. So we invite you all to be a part of that meeting, and it will be a hybrid meeting. So you can attend from home or here in the room. You will be able to vote from home, and we'll let you vote here in the room too. So, but plan to put that on your calendar. It's a wonderful time of reaffirming our wholeness, our vision, our moving forward as a unity of Michiana spiritual community. As I mentioned a little bit, the Wednesday discussion and meditation group, we have been gathering and talking about ideas and then finishing with a time of meditation and prayer. The date has not been set yet, but it'll be towards the end of this month when we will begin like a six-week discussion, reading, study of Linda Martella-Witsit's wonderful, wonderful new book, this concept of affirmative prayer and our own divinity, acknowledging our oneness as co-creators with God. So plan to join that. We'll give you more information later. And then we have been mentioning, because we don't know if we're going to have, who knows, Punxsutawney Phil said we're going to have a good spring, but we may have some more winter, we may have some more snow, and so what we want you to be aware of, because we are not always sure about whether we'll meet in person or just simply by live stream, we will still continue to have a service, because bless Kevin's heart, he has the capacity to be able to run one of our past services from his computer at home. So the only thing that we have in question at times is whether or not we'll actually also meet in person. So if you have a question on a Sunday when there's been some snow, we will post by 8 a.m. on that Sunday morning. We'll post it on our website, on our Facebook page, on our app, and we can also let you know by email. We'll send that out as well. So that's how you will know that you may not want to show up here and be the only one here on on a snowy morning. So that concludes our announcements for today, and as we take time to center in the consciousness of the abundance of the universe comes from the source of all, Yahweh, the breath of life, the beingness. And as we affirm that, as that is our creative visioning for unity of Michiana and for all of our lives, we manifest that forth as a vibrant, abundant spiritual community and a place to join together. And so as you take your love offering either in your hand, well, just hold in this consciousness that infinity strip. And know that you can contribute, if you're here in the room, there's a love offering basket in the back, contribution basket. You can contribute on unitymichiana.org or on our app. We are grateful in affirming this is our spiritual community. We are each a vibrant part of, and we contribute from our heart, from our very being, in whatever way that we can. And so let us affirm our prosperity statement. I am an open channel through which God's love and abundance freely flows. I give and receive with confidence and gratitude. And so we feel our entire being just fairly vibrating with an excitement, with an awareness of its limitless nature, the potentiality to create, to draw forth through our affirmative prayer, our affirmative focus, our visioning dreams. We let that flow easily through us into manifestation in our world. And we're grateful for the abundance in all its forms that lifts us up and moves us forward in wondrous and positive ways. Thank you, God. Amen. Now let's all stand and sing our peace song.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, a peace that was meant to be. With God's heart created, family all are we. Let us walk with each other in perfect harmony. Let peace begin with me. Let this be our moment now. With every step I our solemn vow, take each moment and live each moment in peace eternally. Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin.
The light of God surrounds us, the love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. And so it is, and so we allow it to be. Thanks, everyone. It's wonderful to see you. Look forward to seeing you next week. Blessings. Thank you.
God in this room. When I fell out of the cloud, I hit the ground and I noted something missing. Someone she has seen me change.